All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Richard Pearce. He's the CEO of South Star Battery Metals. And Richard, it's good to see you. How are you?
Steve, thanks for having me. Doing well, thanks.
Yeah, some exciting news out from the company today. We'll get to that in just a second, but maybe you give an opportunity here to talk about South Star. Give me a little background on the company.
Sure. So we basically put the project into the shell basically in 2018. I've been involved with the project since 2010-ish. So Brazil has a long history of successfully producing graphite. The Santa Cruz project itself is 100% permitted for phase one operations. We've got a robust 43-101 basically queued up for construction. 12-month construction and commissioning schedule for phase one, which will basically get us 5,000 tons. Then we'll be stepping up to 25,000 tons in phase two and 50,000 tons in phase three. So basically a very short fuse to basically get to production. Then we have also have a project in Alabama, which is a little bit earlier stage. It's about 2 years behind where we are. It's all on private land, private tenements. We think it's a fantastic project to be the next producer for us in the pipeline, and just excited about what's going on.
Richard, can you talk a bit more about graphite? Because I think a lot of people hear graphite and they think, you know, oh, it's, you know, a golf driver, things like that, but they don't understand the importance of graphite. And I think it's important that you sort of separate away from what that graphite is and the graphite that you're looking for.
Yeah, think of graphite basically in two buckets, right? You have industrial applications, which is high strength steels, refractories, lubricants, brake pads, et cetera. And that's growing more or less at about, you know, GDP or, you know, plus or minus. Then the other portion of it is really focused on value add component, where you take concentrates, you upgrade it to in some way, shape or form to something that's significantly higher in terms of grade for battery applications, for energy, for foils, for expandable graphites, fire retardants, et cetera. So there's basically two main markets for it. You know, it's an ounce of copper or an ounce of gold is an ounce of gold, and a pound of copper is a pound of copper. You know, you can sell it. Industrial metals in general is a little bit more nuanced. And if you look out across the different applications, there's different requirements as it relates to grain size fraction, as it relates to chemical composition, shaping, those types of things. So, again, I think one of the great things that we have about South Star is that it's principally a large flake graphite deposit in Brazil. Mm-hmm. It's very pure ore, so it easily concentrates as well as purifies, very low contaminants. We're one of just a couple companies, for example, that are being tested in the Oak Ridge lab for nuclear applications. And I think to complement what we have in Brazil, the project in Alabama is a complementary sort of deposit. You know, in Brazil, it's about 2/3 larger flake material and 1/3 finer. And basically Alabama is the exact mirror of that, where it's about 2/3 fine and about 1/3 larger flake. So when you're looking out across the battery metal space, for example, they're looking for principally fines. When you're looking for refractories or expandables or things like that, they're looking for large flake or larger flake characteristics. So what you want to be able to do is profitably sell 100% of whatever it is you're producing, not have stockpiles of material sitting on the ground that you can't sell, and you're actually able to place 100% of what you're producing. So graphite is a little bit more nuanced than gold, copper, zinc, or the typical metals. There is no publicly public exchange actually trade it. So typically it's, you know, company to company, person to person, those types of sales. So it's a little bit more opaque, but again, I think that'll change over time. And the market is growing exponentially. So when you look at the value add component, it's growing 30% per year. And kind of the meat and potatoes industrial applications are growing at 3%, 4%, 5% annually. So for companies that want to be successful, you have to be able to reach across different markets, different sectors, and different client bases, and have a very diversified portfolio of products, clients and sectors that you can sell profitably into, and obviously compete with Asian production and cost and things like that. So again, I think that's it's really important to be in that first quartile of cost so that you be competitive throughout any inevitable commodity cycle that, that happens, regardless of whether we want it to or not.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense for sure. Hey, a couple of pieces of news I want to ask you about. You heard from the Brazilian Mining Authority just recently. Tell me about the okay you got from them and what that allows you to do now.
So basically, when you look out across a mining project, you need two main permits, right? One is the environmental permit and the other is the mining license. So we submitted most of our reports for the mining license back in 2015, 2016. So again, thanks to a lot of the techs and the folks that looked through the material, we finally got all 13 of our claims approved. So we have a huge land package, 13 claims, about 13,000 hectares. We're one of the largest land packages for graphite in Brazil currently. Mm-hmm. So for us, that was an important step in being able to move to the final mining license. We have a trial mining license for one of our main claims. And then the next steps are basically to take six or seven of these main areas that we have, apply for the actual final mining concession. So with these reports now being approved, next step is basically to submit the preliminary economic assessment for the Brazilian authorities, which we're looking to do here over the next 4 to 6 weeks. And then typically it takes about 12 to 14, 16 months to get your final mining license approved. So basically about the time that we're commissioning our phase one plant, we should have our final permits in place for the mining. And again, our environmental permitting is basically a mirror image. It runs in parallel with the mining license. Okay. And we have that basically in hand for our phase one operations. And in the same time frame, we'll be submitting all the same documents we submit for the mining license, we submit for the environmental license. And it's basically just a bigger footprint than what we've submitted currently.
Okay. And in preparation for that, last question is, you've also beefed up your staff as well, working on the construction and operations of that eventual area, right? You've added some team members.
Yeah. Hallelujah. You know, nobody does anything on their own these days. And with junior mining companies, you wear about 10 different hats. So we've been very, very fortunate to be able to go out and hire some really top people to kind of help us build this thing out. We've internalized, so the company itself is going to be doing the EPCM. We will have an engineering company that basically did the final design, handled the field engineering and things like that. And then procurement, supply chain, as well as construction management is going to be handled by us. So a couple of key pieces that we've added recently is the general mine manager, the construction manager for the phase one plant, planning. We've also hired our commercial director, who has got vast experience in the graphite space, both for Brazilian graphite companies, which again is the largest producer outside of China, as well as some of the other main players. So he's been involved in natural flake graphite for quite a while. Most recently, he's been involved with synthetic graphite. So a guy that has 15 plus experience playing in the graphite space, both on natural as well as on synthetic. So just excited about having everybody on board, controller. So we're basically all staffed up and ready to start construction and stick some shovels in the ground and get this thing going.
There you go. Exciting times. Richard, thank you so much. Great update. Good to see you. And we'll talk again soon.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Steve.
All right. Richard Pearce, the CEO of South Star Battery Metals.